Hello friends, in this video we will discuss how to calculate normal force on inclined surfaces. In the last video we have discussed how to calculate normal force on flat surfaces and in elevator. So please do watch last videos to go in detail. So inclined surface is the surface which is not flat and makes some angle theta with the horizontal. Like this blue surface is the flat surface. It's completely horizontal. But this yellow surface is an inclined surface because it's making some angle theta with the horizontal. This theta can have any values like 30 degree, 45 degree or 60 degree. As the angle increases, inclination of the surface would increase as well. Suppose this is the box which is kept on this inclined surface. So you know normal force always act perpendicular to the surface. So here on the flat surface normal force act at 90 degree from the surface. 90 degree means perpendicular. The same way this is the inclined surface, so this surface will apply normal force on this box at the 90 degree or the perpendicular to the surface. So basically if an object or box is kept on an inclined surface, there are two forces acting. First force is applied by this inclined surface, which is the normal force. And the second force is applied by this box. You know box has the weight, so its weight or force of gravity would act exactly downward. On the inclined surfaces, we have little different coordinate system. You know, on the flat surface, we take x-axis parallel to the flat surface like this. This would be the x-axis or the horizontal. And perpendicular to the flat surface would be the y-axis. We use same technique for the inclined surface. So parallel to the inclined surface would be the x-axis. And perpendicular or at 90 degree would be the y-axis. So you can see the normal force is exactly along the y-axis. So it is the vertical force. While the force of gravity is neither along the x-axis nor along the y-axis. So it's neither the horizontal force or nor the vertical force. So first of all we need to break this force of gravity in x and y component. So for that we need to find the angle of force of gravity from the x-axis. Suppose this angle is phi. You know the angle of inclined surface is theta. So we make this triangle like this. This is our FG and it is inclined surface and this one is theta. We have to find phi. So this angle is the 90 degree. So phi would be 90 minus theta. So x component of force of gravity would be, we can write it FGx, FG cos phi. This will give us FG cos 90 minus theta and cos 90 minus theta equals sin theta. So the x component of FG would be FG sin theta. The same way y component, the formula is FG sin phi because phi is the angle of force of gravity. We have already learned these formulas for x and y components in vector series. So please watch all videos of vectors to understand these formulas. FG sin 90 minus theta. Sin 90 minus theta equals cos theta. So it would give us FG cos theta. So we can break in the figure also. FG, x component of FG is FG sin theta. And the y component of FG is FG cos theta. You can memorize these two things because This whole calculation is true for all problems on inclines. So now we can make the force equation for vertical forces only. There are two vertical forces. First is Fn and second is Fg cos theta. Addition of vertical forces equals to zero. Box is not moving upward or downward. It's not moving perpendicular to the inclined surface. So the vertical acceleration is zero. So m times zero is zero. So net vertical force equals to zero. And net vertical force would be addition of these two vertical forces. Fn is upward along the positive y-axis, so it's positive. While Fg cos theta is downward along the negative y-axis, so it's negative. This equals to zero. So F1 equals to Fg cos theta. You know Fg, a force of gravity, equals mg. Fg equals m times g. We can plug in this value here, mg cos theta. So this is the formula of normal force on inclined surfaces. This formula is true for all inclined surfaces when friction force is negligible. We will discuss friction force in the next videos. So stay tuned and study more. Don't forget to subscribe, share and like for daily updates. Thank you.